Hi! Today's video was created in cooperation with Medel, and I will talk about Rondo 3, a wireless streaming and wireless charging audio processor. Rondo 3 is light, extremely slim, has no cables, and you don't need to change any batteries. Take a look at how it looks on my head. Rondo 3 charges wirelessly. Let me show you how it works. To start charging Rondo 3 wirelessly, plug the USB cable into the charging pad. Plug the other end into the wall plug adapter or a USB port. Place the Rondo 3 on the wireless charging pad with a Medel logo facing upwards. Make sure the Medel logo is at the exact center of the charging pad. Rondo 3 will automatically switch off when placed on the wireless charger. The orange charging indicator light on the Rondo 3 will illuminate while charging. When the lights go off, Rondo 3 is fully charged. This should take 2.5 to 4 hours. Charging Rondo 3 overnight for a full day of the hearing is recommended. As you can see, charging Rondo 3 is incredibly simple. The Rondo 3 audio processor has over 30 different cover designs to choose from. This is how you can change between them. To change Rondo 3's cover, first insert your fingernail into one of the grooves of either side of the socket between the processor and the current cover. Then, gently lift the cover up to remove it. Hold the new cover over the microphone openings of the processor and push down until it snaps into place. Then, gently press down on the edges of the cover to ensure it has snapped into place. You just need to repeat the process to change your style. It's very easy. Rondo 3's covers should be changed every 3 months to maintain your best possible hearing. There are a variety of covers to choose from, so you can customize your audio processor. Check out all of the different covers in the link provided in the video description below. Rondo 3's one-button design makes it incredibly simple to turn your audio processor on and off. Let's take a closer look. To switch on Rondo 3, press the on-off button in the center of the audio processor cover for approximately 2 seconds. When the audio processor is turned on, the main indicator light will fade to white. The main indicator light will then blink blue to show which program is activated. The indicator light will blink red if the link monitoring function is activated. The indicator light will blink green when Rondo 3 is correctly placed on your head. Rondo 3 should be placed over your implant with the Medel logo against your head and the microphones facing upwards. Press the on-off button for about 2 seconds to switch your audio processor off. The white indicator light will fade out once Rondo 3 is off.
So, as you can see, it's as easy as that. With just one press of your Rondo 3, you are good to go. Want to know what the different lights mean on your Rondo 3 audio processor? Let's take a look.
Rondo 3 has 2 indicator lights illuminating or blinking with different patterns and colors to indicate different conditions. The indicator light on the front of the processor is the main indicator light, and the indicator light on the back is the charging indicator light. The charging indicator light glows orange when Rondo 3 is charging. When the light goes off, Rondo 3 is charged. When Rondo 3 is switched on, the main indicator light will fade to white. The light will fade out when Rondo 3 is switched off. The main indicator light blinks blue after changing the program. One blink indicates program 1 is selected, 2 blinks indicate program 2, and so on. A short red blink means that the flight mode has been successfully activated.
If the link monitoring function is activated, the light will blink green 3 times when Rondo 3 is placed over the implant. This shows that Rondo 3 is working correctly and is communicated with your implant. If you have an older generation implant like C40 or C40 Plus, the light will only blink green once. If activated by your audiologist, continuous short green blinks indicate the Rondo 3 communicates with your implant. Continuous short red blinks indicate that Rondo 3 is not communicated with your implant. Switch your audio processor off and on again and ensure that it's charged and positioned over the correct implant. Any other indicator light signals suggest that there may be a technical issue with your Rondo 3. Contact your CI center for further assistance. The FineTuner Echo is a remote control that lets you change settings on your Rondo 3 audio processor. Let's see how to set it up and start using it. Before using the FineTuner Echo, you have to pair it with your audio processor. Switch off Rondo 3 and place it on the back or front of the FineTuner Echo. Now switch Rondo 3 back on. It will pair automatically with the FineTuner Echo. Try it again if your processor does not pair immediately with the FineTuner Echo. If it still does not work, please contact your audiologist to ensure your audio processor is programmed correctly. All FineTuner Echo functions can be performed with either the left processor, right processor, or both processors. To choose which processor or processors you wish to perform the function with, press the corresponding processor selection key. To turn up the volume with the FineTuner Echo, press the upper volume key. To turn the volume down, press the lower volume key. Press the upper sensitivity key to increase the sensitivity of your audio processor's microphones. This will increase the range of the microphones, but you may also increase background noise levels. Press the lower sensitivity key to decrease the sensitivity of your audio processor's microphones. The default key sets volume and sensitivity back to predefined values set by your audiologist. Pressing default will not change your program. To select the program, press the program selection key. The top bar at the top of the screen indicates your current program. Press and hold the empty button for 3 seconds to mute your microphones until the mute symbol is displayed. To unmute your microphones, press the empty button for 3 seconds again. You can also activate the connection with AudioLink and lock your keypad. You can also use your FineTuner Echo to check that the audio processor microphones are working properly. First, ensure Rondo 3 is on, then place it on the back or front of the FineTuner Echo. Speak into the audio processor microphones. The green light on the FineTuner Echo should flicker to the rhythm of your voice. Adjust the volume setting on your FineTuner Echo if the green light does not flicker. If the green light still does not flicker, charge your audio processor fully and try again. If your Rondo 3 is still not working correctly, contact your CI center for assistance. And that's it! Now you can use your FineTuner Echo with Rondo 3. With the AudioKey 2 app, you can control your Rondo 3's settings, check on your child's hearing, view detailed stats, and even locate your lost audio processor, all from your phone. But first, you need to pair it. I will show you how to do that with an iOS device. If you are using AudioKey 2 with Rondo 3 for the first time, make sure that you have Bluetooth enabled on your phone. Restart your Rondo 3 and position it close by. Open the AudioKey 2 app. The pairing screen should automatically appear. Then select the direct connection option and tap Next. If the pairing screen doesn't appear automatically, navigate to your profile and under Audio Processor, tap Pair Now. Turn Rondo 3 off and then on again. Then select the direct connection option and tap Next. AudioKey 2 will automatically pair with your device. Once your audio processor is paired, tap Next, assign a user to the audio processor. If it's your audio processor, select your own account and tap Next. If the audio processor belongs to your child or someone you look after, then select the corresponding user from the list. Tap Create New User, then Next, enter their name and tap Create. Your audio processor is now paired with AudioKey 2. Now I will show you how to pair your Rondo 3 with an Android device. If you are using AudioKey 2 with Rondo 3 for the first time, make sure that you have Bluetooth enabled on your phone. Restart your Rondo 3 and position it close by. Open the AudioKey 2 app. Then select the direct connection option and tap Next. AudioKey 2 will automatically pair with your device. Once your audio processor is paired, tap Next. Assign a user to the audio processor. If it's your audio processor, select your own account and tap Next. If the audio processor belongs to your child or someone you look after, then select the corresponding user from the list. Tap Create New User, then Next, enter their name and tap Create. Your audio processor is now paired with AudioKey 2. For more details about what you can do with AudioKey 2, visit Medal's AudioKey 2 page. The link is provided in the video description below. Want to go swimming with your Rondo 3 audio processor? Here's how you can use WaterWear with Rondo 3. WaterWear is a cover for the Rondo 3 audio processor that provides complete water protection for activities such as swimming. It consists of the main WaterWear cover and the round adhesive strip. To attach WaterWear to your Rondo 3, ensure your hands are clean and dry. Hold Rondo 3 with the metal logo facing upwards. Insert Rondo 3 into WaterWear by placing the end with the padlock symbol into the side with the rectangular flap. Hold Rondo 3 between two fingers and grab the circular shaped flap with your other hand. Pull WaterWear over the entire processor. Make sure the cover fits snugly around the processor without any wrinkles or air bubbles. Place the round adhesive strip over the flat side of the processor, starting at the circular flap. There should be no gaps between the strip and the cover. Now you are ready to go swimming with your Rondo 3 audio processor. Check this out! Using WaterWear, your Rondo 3 is protected from water. Let me show you how to remove WaterWear. To remove WaterWear, gently peel off the adhesive strip and discard. Use the circular flap to remove the cover from the processor. Each WaterWear cover can be used up to 3 times, but the adhesive strip needs to be replaced every time. In the end, I have technical information that may be useful in everyday use. When fully charged, Rondo 3 lasts from morning to night, so you can use it all day without worrying about changing some batteries or recharging your audio processor during the day. Thank you for today and see you in the following videos.